Hey all, welcome to another video and welcome to the next part of our Villa Intercom mini series. And today we are just looking at the screen and we're going to be going over all the menus and settings and things like that. Okay, one thing I have to mention though, I do apologize about the quality of the recording on the screen. I don't know why it doesn't look like this in real life, but anytime you put a phone on it, you get these kind of crazy lines. It doesn't look like this in real life. It's purely a recording thing. Okay, guys, but I'm trying my best here, so do bear with me. All right, so first things first, let's show you how to turn off the screen. Well, not turn off the screen, turn off the light on the screen. So you've got this little light bulb here, and this literally can just turn it on and off. Okay, so if you don't like it on, you don't want to waste electricity or whatever, guys, just hit that button there. And for some reason, if the time does is incorrect, then you can change it by just clicking on the time. But if you do watch our videos, guys, you'll be able to set it up perfectly so it syncs to the internet and you should never have a problem with the time. So check out the videos earlier on in the series about the time. All right, so we've got the call button here. So if you have other screens in the house, or you can call them, okay? But we only have our outdoor station connected right now. Messages here, so you can, if you have any messages or notifications, be able to see them there. The live view, we can check out our live view of our camera, which is set up just in my recording station here. And then any IP cameras, you can go here and check them out. And settings, okay, this is where a lot of things are. So on the main menu, you can choose your ringtone duration, calling duration, forward, call forwarding as well, volume settings here, guys, which is quite handy to have here. Okay, and other settings, let's have a look at this. Okay, do not disturb mode, you can put on as well, just in case you want to silence it. Okay, then we've got Wi-Fi here, guys, if you want to enable your Wi-Fi, but this is really only if you want to set your screen up without using PoE. Okay, don't really use that one, I'm afraid. General settings here, I recommend, guys, do not touch the password settings here. Time and date, like I said, guys, it's easier, it's best if you just watch our videos. Now, if you do want to change the language, go ahead and change it here. And we've got brightness. This is a handy one here. So I might increase it a little bit. Clean screen, okay? Okay, so if you want to clean the screen, guys, put this on, I guess. And then you got clean the screen for 30 seconds without it being touch enabled. Which is quite an interesting feature there, guys. I didn't even know about that. Okay, and if you put a card in here, it will tell you about your card details. And now we're going to our advanced settings, okay? So here you can also find your device information. We've got the serial numbers, model, version, all that stuff, okay? And you can also reboot the device from here. And these kind of things are worth rebooting every now and then, guys, right? Just a little tip there. And output settings, okay? This is generally never not used, so I wouldn't worry about that. So let's go into configuration and we can look at some more advanced pages. Okay, so it tells you the station type. So this is an indoor station, not an extension, which means it's your main screen, okay? And then we've got the room information. So it's just basically, yeah, just nothing special here. The live view duration, you can increase that if you wanted to, if you like to view your CCTV on the main panel where you've got the live cameras, you can increase the duration here. I know some people bought this and they thought this could have this on all the time, but 60 seconds is the maximum for that. Okay, guys, I wouldn't be touching the SIP settings unless you know what you're doing. Email address, you can pop in an email here if you're interested. Okay, and then we've got our network settings. Now, really, guys, if your intercom is set up, do not touch this, okay? Do not touch anything here, all right? And then we've got our device management. So this is generally here, so we can add IP cameras or your DVR cameras here, and you can also change you can mess around with your extension settings as well. Okay, so really, unless you know what you're doing, guys, I really wouldn't touch this. Okay, and then we've got our system maintenance. Okay, so here we got all we default our panel and the upgrade feature, guys. I really wouldn't rely on this. I've never managed to get it to work, to be honest with you. And we've got here unlink app account. Okay, so if you're inheriting the system from someone else, you want to unlink the app account so you can link it to yourself. And if you did want to start again with the app, you go to Hik-Connect services here, and we have all our settings here for our app. Okay, so you can enable this. You've got your verification code and everything right here. All right, so that pretty much is just the basic run through of the screen, guys. Okay, nothing special really, but a couple of interesting features in there, and a few interesting settings to check out, like the brightness and the sound and things like that, which you can change on your own. But that pretty much wraps up this video, so thanks for watching, and hopefully catch you on another one. Cheers, bye bye.